Hello everybody. So we have discussed about optical fibers in the last class, and I'll just give an introductory note about optical fibers, that is why optical fibers and what are the prominent properties of optical fibers that makes it peculiar. And now we are going to, in this class we are going to discuss different types of optical fibers. That is how we are going to classify the optical fibers. That is based on the material it is made of. It is classified into three. That is, it is having a, basically a, optical fiber will be having a core and a cladding and a sheath surrounding the both. And for a first category based on the material is plastic core with plastic cladding. The second category is plastic core with glass cladding, and the third one is glass core with glass cladding. Okay, and based on the mode of transmission, optical fibers are classified into two, that is single mode fiber and multi mode fiber. And another way of classification, basically you might have studied in your plus two classes and all, is on the basis of refractive index, they are classified into step index fiber and graded index fiber. So in this class, we are going to discuss this classification of this optical fiber. It's a very short class. We'll discuss different types of optical fibers based on materials, based on mode of propagation, and based on index profile. Okay, some of the optical fibers will be having plastic core and a plastic cladding. This type of fiber cable have same material for the core and cladding. It is very easy to produce. It is less expensive since it is made of plastic, and it is easy to install. And it is generally used for short distance communication channels. And second one is glass core with plastic cladding. It is abbreviated as PCS. And the signal loss is very less affected by external electromagnetic radiations and all. And it is generally used for this military application. And you can see the fiber here, that is glass core is having what, like 0.001965 inch in diameter. Then it will be having a plastic cladding and all. No, you just need to know this classification only, not about the technological details and all. And the third one is glass core with glass cladding. It is known as SCS. And it is having the most good one, and it is having the lowest signal loss than PCS, and it is generally used in high radiation areas. So there would be lowest interference or lowest disturbances or lowest distractions from external environment. It is the best one used in regions that are susceptible to radiation. Okay. So, plastic core, plastic cladding, glass core, plastic cladding, glass core with glass cladding. So, made on the based on the mode of transmission, it is again classified into single mode fiber. Single mode, from the name itself, it is clear that single mode means only having, it will be having a single ray path. And the core will be having a very small diameter from 7 to 10 micrometer. And it can transmit bandwidth up to 40 gigahertz. And the single mode fiber is generally used for long distance communication and low cost circuits like TV cables and all. And you can see the transmission of light ray through a single mode fiber. And you can see a single ray which is transmitting along the axis of the fiber. And the second one in this classification is multimode fiber. From the name itself, it is again understood, means there will be more than one ray path. Light take more than one path to travel. So if we have more than one ray path, means it will be having a greater diameter. The core will be having a greater diameter ranging from 20 to 100 micrometer, and it is generally used for medium distance communication and high bandwidth communication. And in the picture you can see there will be a lot of zigzag ray paths within the fiber. This is the core, and the other two areas is called the cladding. So if we just make a comparative study between multimode fiber and single mode fiber, and you can see here there will be source of light and here there will be a detector to detect the light. Multimode means there will be a large number of ray paths. Single mode means it will be having a smaller diameter and a one ray path. And it is low cost sources can be used in this case. And in this case, high cost sources have to be used. And the connectors and all, in between, there need to be connectors, the source connecting to the cable and all. And low cost connector can be used in multimode fiber, means in single mode. Since only there is a single ray path, the cost of the connectors and installation cost is very high. And here, the lower cost for connectors and lower installation cost. And fiber cost is very high in the case of multimode, but fiber cost is low in the case of single mode. The entire system cost less in the case of multimode and in the higher cost for the system in the case of single mode. And the loss is higher, lower bandwidth, and it can be used for distance up to 2 kilometers. And it can be used for distance up to 60 plus kilometers, and it is used, it is having lower loss since there is only one ray path, and it can be used for transmitting higher bandwidth. And it is this multimode transmission is best for LAN, local area network, SAN, data centers and all. And here it is single mode transmission is used for WAN, means wide area network. Then campuses and all, it is used single mode transmission. So hope you understood the difference between multimode and single mode transmission of light through optical fibers. So this is something that you might be at least knowing the technical names and all. On the basis of the refractive index, the classification of optical fiber is made into two, that is step index fiber and graded index fiber. And basically the structure of optical fiber, there will be an inner cylindrical layer, and this inner cylindrical layer is known as core. It is having a diameter, I mean a radius A, and surrounding the core there will be another region which is called the cladding. It is also will be a coaxial cylindrical shape, and the refractive index of the cladding will be always less than that of the core. Core will be having a larger refractive index than that of the cladding. And I can just give optical fiber to be a cylindrical waveguide made of transparent material which is either glass or plastic, and the light is traveling through the optical fiber by the principle of total internal reflection. And again on the base, and why, so the next question is why we need a cladding. So why we need a cladding for transmitting light through an optical fiber? So the answer is to make the diameter of the optical fiber remain constant throughout the length. Any change in thickness of the fiber or the medium outside the fiber will cause the loss of light energy transmitted through. To make the thickness of the fiber uniform, we basically have a cladding and a surrounding region which is known as a jacket or a sheath. And most probably a very large number of reflection occur through a fiber. So in order to confirm that the total internal reflection is occurring through the fiber, even though there is some sort of bend, we need some more coating to protect the light rays, to make the light rays guided within this core. We need a cladding. Okay. And the cladding also causes a reduction in the size of the cone of light that can be trapped. That we will discuss in the later sessions. So cladding of sufficient thickness prevents leakage of light energy from one fiber to another. Normally a cable will be having more than one optical fiber. So if the cladding is having enough thickness, there won't be any leakage of light from one fiber to another. And a part of the light energy, there is a chance for the part of the light energy to penetrate to the fiber surface. So normally the intensity of the light decreases as we move away from the surface. So when fiber touches something else, what happens? The light can leak into the medium and can be scattered away from the fiber. and this can cause a sufficient leakage of life energy. So in order to prevent that, we need a sheath as well as cladding. In order to avoid the spreading or leakage of light, we need a cladding. So what are the things? Why we need a cladding for the fiber means, the answer is, in order to keep the size of the fiber constant, to protect the fiber from physical damage or any sort of surface contamination. And in order to prevent the leakage of light, and in order to prevent the leakage of light from core to the cladding and to the outer sheath. And these are all the reasons why we need a cladding for an optical fiber. So an optical fiber will be having a core. It will be cylindrical shape. It will be surrounded by cladding having a radius B. It is also will be cylindrical shape. And surrounding this, there will be a jacket. It can have, there will be one optical fiber or there will be many optical fibers which will be surrounded by a jacket or a sheath. And what is step index fiber? Means the step index fiber is having a uniform refractive index of the core. I can see the core here. Core is having a diameter radius A. And the whole of the core will be having a refractive index 1. And you can see the refractive index profile here. Here is the center of the core. Core is having a refractive index N1. And the refractive index of core is N1, which is larger than N2. N2 is the refractive index of the cladding. N0 is the refractive index of the air. And we are placing the fiber in the air. And N0 is the refractive index of the air. So N1 is larger than N2. And here, what happens? The cladding region will be having a refractive index N2 all over the cladding region. Core will be having a pakka refractive index. At the core cladding interface, there is an abrupt change in the refractive index. There is a step discontinuity. You can see a step here. So refractive index changes by a step. Here N1, then at the core cladding interface, means at this point, you can see a step variation in the refractive index. That is why it is given the name step index. Step means there is a discontinuity. Index means a refractive index and fiber. And you can see the graph of radial distance. That is the x-axis we are representing the distance and y-axis we are representing the refractive index. Means the refractive index profile will be like that of a step. This is the radius of core. This is the radius of cladding. Hope this is clear. What is a step index fiber? So next classification is what? Graded index fiber. Graded index fiber means it is different from the step index fiber. That is, the refractive index of the core is no longer constant, but it is uniform. It goes on decreasing from the center as it reaches the cladding. Refractive index is highest at the center and decreases till the end of the core. And you can see the refractive index is gradually decreasing from the center to the point where it touches the cladding. And the cladding will be having a uniform refractive index as before. Then N0 is the refractive index outside. And since there is a non-uniform distribution of refractive index moving from the center, it gradually decreases till it reaches the end of the core or beginning of the cladding. That is why it is called graded index fiber. That is, refractive index got graded. That is why it is called the name graded index fiber. So we are going to make a comparative study of single mode fiber over multimode fiber. Single mode fiber means what? We have discussed before. It is having a lower signal loss and transferring high amount of data, that we have made a comparative study before. Okay, this is the same thing and it is written as points. I'll send you this PPT. You just go through the points and you can see the difference. This is a multimode fiber. It is having a, this is a multimode fiber. You can see the radius of the core is larger. That is, multimode fiber having thickness 50 to
125 micrometer core diameter, and here it is 62.5 to 125 micrometer core diameter. Single mode fiber means it need only a single ray path, means the diameter of the core is very small. And again, single mode fiber, you can see, and a multi-mode fiber, and a single mode step index fiber. And you can see, step index fiber means single mode, step index fiber is this one. There will be a correct, a straight line path for the ray if it is a single mode step index fiber. There will be a straight line path, and there will be a single ray path also. And here, this is also step index. And here, how can I differentiate between a step index fiber and a graded index fiber? In a step index fiber, the light ray path will be straight, since the refractive index is uniform in the core region. But it is a multimode graded index fiber. You can see the difference. Here the ray path gets gradually curved because the refractive index is varying continuously. Okay, it is maximum at the center and go on decreasing. So the ray path will be like this way. And all these rays are confined due to the phenomena of total internal reflection. So hope it is clear. The ray path will be straight for a single step index fiber. For a graded index fiber, the ray path will be curved. For a single mode fiber, there will be one ray path, smaller diameter, and for a multi-mode fiber, there will be large number of ray paths and having a greater diameter for the core. Hope it is well understood from the picture shown here. Here also it is shown what is a graded index fiber. Graded index fiber means refractive index decreases, and it is a single mode step index fiber, single ray path, and it is step index, and step index multi-mode means there will be a large number of ray path. Here diameter is small, here diameter is large. This is graded index, this is step index. Ray path is straight, ray path is curved here. Hope it is clear. And here also you can say the path of the ray, variation of the refractive index is curved, means it is graded index. The variation of refractive index is like a step discontinuity, means it is step index. A lot of figures are shown here. The difference between single mode, multi-mode, step index, graded index, that is what we have discussed in the last slides also. Okay, so propagation of light through optical fiber. By grading the index profile in the core, the pulse broadening is reduced. And I'll discuss what is pulse broadening and all, and then it will be more clear for you. However, this is the propagation of light through a optical fiber, single mode optical fiber, a step index optical fiber. This is means it is a multi-mode graded index fiber. And in the case of a graded index optical fiber, a longer path is located in the low index region, and large time taken is compensated by the faster ray traveling, leading to less pulse broadening that we'll discuss later. And here you can see, if it is ray is near to the axis of the core, what happens? It will take a shorter path, it will reach fastly. And if it is moving toward the lower refractive index region, means the ray path will be very large. Here there is one ray which get what happens, it is have to travel a short distance. But those rays which are traveling towards the near to the cladding, means it will have a longer ray path. So what happens, different rays reach at different times when it come out of the fiber. That means pulses getting broadened. Normally in multimode fibers, there will be a chance for pulse broadening. However, it can be reduced. It is considerably reduced because the longer path is located in the lower refractive index region. The larger time taken is compensated by faster travel, leading to less pulse broadening. The pulse broadening can be reduced considerably because this rays that is taking longer paths travel faster. Then still there will be pulse broadening in the case of multimode fibers as compared to single mode fiber. Pulse get broadened since different rays travel different distances. So, hope you understood. We have discussed about the classification of fibers on the basis of material, on the basis of mode of propagation, and on the basis of refractive index. Three types classification on the basis of material, two type classification on the mode of propagation, and two classification on the basis of refractive index. Hope it is clear for you. In the next class, we'll discuss numerical aperture, then acceptance angle, and some problems. And later on, we'll discuss what is pulse broadening, then what are the application of fiber optics. Basically, it sensors in a little bit detail. Then we'll discuss the applications of optical fiber. With that, we'll complete this chapter. Right. So we'll stop this class here. Okay. If you are having any doubts, you just come to me, discuss in the group, or come to me personally. Thank you.